It's a type 5 wetland. It is a man-made wetland. It was developed mainly for the purposes of water quality. You have salts, you have oils, you have fertilizers. All that comes with that runoff into the wetland. The wetland does its thing. Water quality, it filters, it absorbs. Good to go?
Okay.
Everybody knows.
For their studies, they're doing an environmental study. We have wetlands all around here in Minnesota. And gets the kids out, hands-on, walking around in the environment.
It's really fun back there when you see the diversity of life and what there is.
Part of our curriculum, we study wetlands and the importance of wetlands.
We use this net and scoop the animals.
Let's bring it over here.
So what's the location again?
We went right by the pond.
Well, we found a frog, a diving beetle, a back swimmer, and well, a lot of snails.
You got a spider?
Yeah.
Where is he?
Okay, there's a snail.
And then after this, we're going to do pH testing, oxygen testing.
Now do you shake it?
Water quality test. So we're checking for orthophosphate, the amount of phosphorus in the water. We're checking for dissolved oxygen, and we're checking for pH.
To see if the wetlands are healthy. If the wetlands aren't healthy, lots of the animals and plants are probably going to die.
We get special permission to come here and do our collecting and our survey work. And we've been doing survey work for the past 10, 12 years.
And we give the information that we collect, we give that to the city of Shorewood, and we also give it to the watershed district.
10, so is that a good reading?
Oh yeah, it's nice and clear.
So I've had kids go to the city council and they've presented and given our information so that they know that this information is meaningful to the community as well as to their environment and to their world.
If we didn't, the wetlands would die out, and our wetlands act as a sponge to soak up water for a flood or a storm. If we wouldn't that, it would start flooding.